Hello everybody and welcome to the MerwinMusic YouTube channel. In this video we're going to turn this old sewing machine into a pickup winder. Okay, so I am certainly not the first person to ever come up with this idea of turning an old sewing machine into a pickup winder, and that's just because it's the perfect thing to do so. This was super cheap, it was $6 at Goodwill, and we already have in here a variable speed motor and a foot pedal to control it with, and that's already most of the way there for having a pickup winder. So I could just slap a pickup on the back here and spin it up and wind a pickup. But we're going to go a little bit farther and we're going to take this thing apart and kind of rebuild it for the purpose of being a pickup winder. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is open up this sewing machine and take out all the useful pieces. Okay, so I think I have all the parts that I need. We have this whole piece right here, which is our motor and our plug for our power cord and foot switch and power switch. It's also wired up into this light bulb that we might use. Next up, we have kind of this main drive shaft, and I kept the bearings that was mounted in, and the gear from the handle, so we can use the same belt and hook that up to the motor like that. And then in order to mount it, we'll make little brackets that'll hold in these. And I kept the little plates and screws that was in. And I think the plan then is we'll make a plate that'll mount on this end, and that'll be what the pickup attaches to wind it up. And that's really all we need for the winder. And now the last piece to make this work is I picked up this 5-digit counter here. So it's got a little magnet reader on here and a little screen. And we can see here with that counter, when a magnet passes over this end right here, it counts how many times it's gone by. So I think the plan will be to take this magnet and we'll just glue it in right on this piece right here. So every time this spins around, it'll move past this counter and it'll tell us how many windings we have on our pickup. Okay, so the first thing that I did was found this scrap of 1/2-inch thick Baltic birch plywood, and this is going to be a disc that I can mount the pickup to. So with a spare pickup that I had laying around, I found that a pretty good size was a 5-inch diameter circle, so I could set my compass to 2.5 inches, draw out the circle, cut it out on the bandsaw, and then clean up that cut on the disc sander. Next, I needed to drill a hole in the middle, and I wanted this to be undersized from what the shaft from the sewing machine is. So for me, this ended up being a 3/8-inch size drill bit. And I can put that in the drill press and then rotate the disc every so often while I'm drilling the hole so I can get as perpendicular of a hole as possible, since this will help have less wobble on the disc when it's all said and done. Next, I ripped another piece of Baltic birch plywood down to 4 inches at the table saw, and then with a Forstner bit, I drilled 2 holes from the edge of the plywood. Now the sizes of Forstner bit that I had were either too small so the bearing didn't fit, or they were much too big so it was really loose. So what I did is I used the drill bit size that was just a little bit too small, and then I could clean it out with a chisel so I got a nice tight fit. So you can see here that it creates a channel with kind of curved sides, so it holds that bearing in place so it can't fall out either direction. So when those were fitting nicely and they sat all the way down in the bottom, I could mark how high that needed to be and cut off the extra on top,
so that those brackets that I saved from the sewing machine can help hold those down so they don't work themselves up out the top. So now that I had the bearings fitting nicely in this one piece, I cut it apart into two sections at the bandsaw, just giving it a nice little trapezoid shape so it would look better. And you can see here how that holds up now our drive shaft on just those bearings. But this whole assembly will have a tendency to want to rack side to side. So to fix that, I cut down an old piece of 2x4 that would fit inside those two sections and really sturdy up the whole assembly. Next, I found a piece of plywood that would work for the base of the machine. Now, mine ended up being about 12 by 14 inches, but you really just need something that's going to be big enough to hold all of the components down. So then I could lay out where I wanted the main drive shaft and screw that into the base from underneath. Then I had to rather inelegantly pound the drive shaft into that undersized hole on my disc that will hold the pickup. Now, this isn't the greatest way to make sure that it stays perfectly true to that face and perpendicular, but thankfully you can kind of bend it after the fact, and mine wasn't too far off, as long as that hole ends up being pretty square. Next, I had to come up with a way to mount the motor to the base. Now, even though it has these nice flanges for screwing down, I couldn't just screw it to the base because of where the power cord came out in the way. So I had to take some more plywood and cut kind of this funny looking J piece so that I could raise the motor up a little bit, make room for that power cord, and still be able to screw it down to the base. So then I could just drill some countersunk holes for some screws to hold this whole piece down, and I made sure to line it all up and get the spacing good based on the belt from the sewing machine. Now, one problem that I ran into is that the gear assembly for the sewing machine shaft had sort of like a clutch built into it, so this piece of plastic here could move out of the way of this cross piece, and it would just spin freely, not actually driving the shaft. So I had to cut a sort of little donut out of some more half-inch plywood. So I drilled a hole in the middle and then cut the outside on my bandsaw. And you can see here when I push that drive piece in that engages with the shaft, then I can put the spacer in and then the gear, and that all locks together and it can't disengage with that clutch anymore. And that all gets held back on with the same pin that I saved when I took it apart. So with that sorted out, I could screw down the plates that hold the bearings in place, and I could screw down my motor, making sure that the placement was good for the belt tracking and tension. Now I needed to focus on adding the magnetic pickup winding counter to this machine. So I cut out this funny little shaped piece to be a stand for the screen. You can see it fits in there, has room for the wires to come out the back, and that whole piece just simply gets screwed to the machine from underneath. Next, I drilled a little recess in this plastic piece attached to the drive shaft so that I could have a nice spot to hold a magnet in with some 5-minute epoxy. And then I could simply take this whole magnet reader assembly, and with the little bracket that came with it, I can screw that to the base of the machine and it will hold it just in the right place so that it will line up with that magnet when it spins around. Now, in hindsight, I should have attached this screw before I put the motor on since it was in the way and it was kind of a pain, but eventually I did get it. Now, the last thing that I did was decide to put that light bulb that came with the sewing machine to good use. So I just used a scrap piece of wood and drilled a 5/8 inch hole in it so I could use a dowel rod to screw the light bulb to. And this will just put it right behind the pickup so when I'm wrapping windings around it, I can see that wire a little bit easier. And with that, the machine was done. I did put some little rubber feet on the bottom just to stop it from sliding around, but then I could bring it down to the basement, plug it in, turn it on, use some double-sided tape to attach the pickup bobbin, and all I had to do is start winding some pickups. But we're gonna keep this video just about building the actual machine. Don't worry, there's gonna be a super awesome special video just all about winding pickups with this machine, so make sure to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss that video when it comes out. But otherwise, thank you for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time.